I am Ajay Saroj, hashtag Mr. Cool. In previous lecture, we studied the biological science. Now, in lecture, we study the kingdom Monera. So, kingdom Monera is a basically consist of bacteria. Bacteria, there are various types of bacteria in kingdom Monera, and we know that also in previous lecture I teach characters of kingdom Monera or five kingdom. These all in this lecture we specify only kingdom Monera. In kingdom Monera is consist of bacterias. There are in our hands hundreds of bacteria or millions of bacteria are present, and bacteria are the most abundant microorganism which is present everywhere. In the hundreds of bacteria are present in a handful of a soil. When we take up one handful of a soil, in our hand there are hundreds of bacteria are present, and they also live in extreme habitats such as hot springs, desert, snow and deep ocean. Many are a parasite. There are many bacteria are a parasite, and their lifespan are in different extreme habitats such as hot spring in desert areas, snow and deep oceans. These all are habitats to live, the survive the bacteria, and there are many of the bacteria are parasites. Now after that we study about the what is the shape of bacteria, how they are looking, and there are different on the basis of their categories. Based on the shape, bacteria are classified into four category, which is coccus, which is an spherical in shape, bacillus, which is a rod in shape, vibrium, which is comma shape, and the spirillum, which is spiral in. So first coccus means spherical in shape, just like a round in shape, and bacillus, which is rod shape, we draw the just like a rod shape, and the vibrium, which is comma, just like that, and the spiral, just like a thread, like a structure in a spiral form. And these all the shape of the bacteria, and these are all in classified into four category. Now examples such as there are examples of bacteria such as these all are examples of bacteria. The first cocci, the examples of cocci, vitrospore, bacilli, flagella and spirilla, these are examples of bacteria on their shape. Now we study structure is very simple of the bacteria, and they are complex in behavior and so metabolic diversity. And bacteria are classified also on their structure, some bacteria are autotrophic and some bacteria are heterotrophic. In autotrophic means they synthesized our food by own or from inorganic substrate, and heterotrophic, which is depend on other animal, and they do not synthesize our food but depend on other organism on dead organic matter for food. These all the autotrophic and heterotrophic bacteria. Now classification of the bacteria. The classification of bacteria is done first. Bacteria are classified into two groups. First, archaebacteria and eubacteria. Then after that, archaebacteria is classified into three groups: halophiles, thermoacidophiles, and methanogenous. Halophiles means which is lived in the salty water. Thermoacidophile, which is acidic in nature and high temperature. Methanogenous, the bacteria which is produced as methane, or just like a cow dung. cowgut in their and cowgut the animals bacteria are live. And the U bacteria are classified into two groups, autotrophs and heterotrophs. Autotrophs are also classified into two groups, photosynthetic autotroph and chemosynthetic autotroph. And heterotrophs are classified into two groups, parasitics and saprophyte. These charts are a classification of bacteria. In this way, bacteria are classified. Now, archaebacteria. The first type is archaebacteria. I say archaebacteria are classified into three groups. First is halophiles, and second is the thermoacidophiles, and third is the methanogens. And these are the live in harsh. The bacteria which is live in a harsh habitat such as salty areas called as halophiles, or a hot spring. The hot springs that is called as thermoacidophiles, and the bacteria which is live in the marshy areas called methanogens. Archaebacteria have a different cell wall structure, and archaebacteria have a different cell wall structure for their survival in extreme condition. There are various condition to live bacteria, and they form different cell wall. Due to different cell wall structure, they survive. Methanogen are present in the guts of ruminant animals, cows, buffaloes. They produce methane from the dung of these animals. Second type is the eubacteria, which is also called as true bacteria. They have a rigid cell wall and flagellum. They are if they are not motile, then they have a rigid cell wall. If they are motile, then they have a flagellum. They include in eubacteria, they include autotrophs and heterotrophs. I say autotrophs are classified into two groups, photosynthetic and chemosynthetic, and heterotrophs are saprophytic and parasite. Now, the first type of the eubacteria is the autotrophic bacteria is the photosynthetic autotroph. Photosynthetic, the example consists of cyanobacteria. Cyanobacteria have a chlorophyll and similar to the and green in color. And cyanobacteria is also called as blue-green algae, which is a unicellular, colonial filamentous, has a and marine terrestrial algae. The colonies are generally surrounded by the gelatinous sheath. The cyanobacteria has a colonies. In there are colonies which are surrounded by the gelatinous sheath, and they often form a blooms in polluted water bodies. They form a blooms just like that blooms and polluted. But some of them fix atmospheric nitrogen in the specialized cell called heterocyst. And in cyanobacteria, there are nitrogens are fix atmospheric nitrogen. Now, examples: nostoc and anabinia. These are constructs in cyanobacteria. This is the structure of nostoc, and this is the heterocyst and anabinia structure, like that. Everything is in just of anabinia structure, and the nostoc, anabinia, anabona, all everything and oscillatoria, these are cyanobacteria. Now, second is the chemosynthetic autotroph. Chemosynthetic means which is use of chemicals for making our food, and that is called chemosynthetic autotroph, or by the help of organic matter. They oxidize. The chemosynthetic autotrophs are oxidized inorganic substances such as nitrates, nitrides, and ammonia, and use the release of energy for their ATP production. And they play a great role, and the chemosynthetic autotrophs play a great role in recycling nutrient. They recycle the nutrients like nitrogen, phosphorus, iron, and sulfur. These all minerals and nutrients are recycled by the chemosynthetic autotrophs. And the third type is the heterotrophic bacteria. In heterotrophic bacteria, these all are heterotrophic bacteria. The rhizobium, these all most of the abundant heterotrophic bacteria, they depend on each other. So there are some heterotrophic bacteria is called lactobacillus, rhizobium, salmonella typhi, vibrio cholera. These are heterotrophic bacteria which is depend on others, and they have impacts of heterotrophic bacteria. And heterotrophic bacteria are used to make a curd from milk. The heterotrophic bacteria is used for making a curd from milk, and also production of antibiotics. Heterotrophic bacteria for production of antibiotics, fixing nitrogen fixation process, and some are pathogens causing damage to human beings. Some heterotrophic bacteria are damage to human being and crops, farm animals, pets. Just example, cholera, typhoid, tetanus, and citrus cancer. These all are causing a pathogen, caused by the pathogens. Now in Kingdom Monera, the Kingdom Monera have three types of reproduction in bacteria. There are reproduction bacteria produced mainly by fission. Fission means one cell divide into two cells. That is fission. Under unfavorable conditions, in Kingdom Monera, there are some bacteria under unfavorable conditions, they also produce a spore. And some they also reproduce by a sort of asexual reproduction by adopting a primitive type of DNA transfer from one bacteria to another bacteria. In some conditions, some bacteria are used to transport transfer a DNA from one bacteria to another bacteria. That is done by the sexual reproduction. And now the mycoplasm. Mycoplasm is without a cell wall. Mycoplasm is a type of bacteria which having a without a cell wall, and they are the smallest living cells known, and they can survive without oxygen. And mycoplasm without survive by the oxygen. Many are pathogenic in animals and plants, and so many mycoplasms bacteria are a